All right, so 4th of July is just around the corner, and usually that means people are going to be out grilling or cooking over an open fire. And so this week's book of the week is actually four different cookbooks with recipes. And the first one I want to talk about is foil packs. Now, these all have glossy pages, and so you don't have to worry about spilling on them. They can wipe up clean pretty easy. They're not the best quality, but they are glossy a little bit, and they're spiral bound, so you can hold them open. It's not like it doesn't have a binding, so you're not constantly trying to find your page and flipping back and forth. You just hold it open to whatever it is you're making. So I really like that. And the foil packs is one of my favorites because the only tool you need is aluminum foil, heavy duty aluminum foil, and you can cook every single thing in this book. And this book has everything from breakfast, lunch, dinner. And the other thing that I really like about this book specifically is every single recipe has a grill instructions and a fire instructions. And so whether you're grilling in the backyard or at a campfire, you can use every single recipe in this book, and you just have to switch between your cooking methods, whether you're doing it on a grill or over the fire. Sometimes it's printed out to a grill at the campfire, but every single recipe in here has both. So I really like that. It's a really cool book. It's got a lot of really, really good recipes in it. The next one is called Barely Roughing It. This one has more advanced meals, and they're more high-end, like buffalo chicken pies, jerked wings, mixed mushrooms, lemon cookies, stuffed peppers, citrus salmon, Swiss steak. There's a breakfast pizza, or not a breakfast, but a dessert pizza in here. I think that's really appetizing. Grilled cherry chocolate pizza, there it is. And so these are a lot more high-end, harder to cook meals. Now these recipes, you're going to need aluminum foil, but you're also going to need a grate, a campfire grate for some of them. And these come in different sizes. There's big ones, so if you have a large family, you might want the big one. If it's just you and your significant other, maybe a littler one will do just fine. You'll also need a pie iron so that you can stick it into the fire and make your different hot sandwiches and apple pies and all the different desserts usually are in here. And then it also says you need mason jars, but a lot of the times when they're using mason jars, they're just using them to store different things. And I found that use jelly jars. Once you finish all the jelly and clean them out, jelly jars usually work at holding food just as well as the mason jars. So depending on your budget, you might want to use the jelly jars instead. And so that's a really good cookbook as well if you like the more fancy meals. The next one is Campfire Treats, and now this one is really interesting. It's got a lot of desserts in there, like cherry stick pies, sandwich skewers, chili cheese fries, taco bowl treats, pineapple upside down cakes. There's a lot of desserts in here, but there's a lot of main meals in here as well. Fire roasted pickle wraps, strawberry morangas, I don't know, it's like chocolate, marshmallow and strawberries. And so it's a more advanced way of cooking. Here we just have pumpkin pies. And so it's a really good book if you have a sweet tooth. This is probably the one you're gonna wanna pick up. And again, some of the recipes in here, some of them are grill specific, some of them are fire specific, but I'm pretty sure you could figure out a way to use them either way, especially if you got your foil packs recipe book and you've been practicing cooking on both the campfire and the grill. You might be able to figure it out from there. The last one I want to talk about today, you're going to need all of the tools as well, and this one is called Put a Little Spark in Your Ash. This is a more well-rounded book right here. It has desserts, it has lunch, breakfast, dinners, appetizers. Here's brat kebabs, here's zippy shrimp. And so it has some really easy things. I think they talk about s'mores in here and the different crackers and marshmallows and candy bars you can use to make your s'mores taste different. And so it has everything from really easy meals to really difficult meals. It has all different kinds of meals, whether it's breakfast, lunch, brunch, dinner, appetizers. It's just a well-rounded cookbook. And so these are the four that I am reviewing, and we have used these. One of these I don't remember which one. I think it was Barely Roughing It, taught us how to use cooler corn, and we've done cooler corn for a long time on this channel, where you put boiling water into a cooler and you cook your corn that way. There's a few recipes in here that we use all the time. And so, with that being said, I want to know what your favorite thing to cook outdoors is, whether it's on a grill or an open fire. Let me know what your favorite outdoor meal to cook is, and I can't wait to see you on my next video.